So, any thoughts on Vivian?
Her beauty's striking.
That is not what I ask.
Still too early to say anything I'd be willing to stand behind. Managed to figure one thing out. She uses powerful magic, masking illusions.
Do you mean to say she might in truth look different than she seems?
Only guessing right now.
We've still some time before Vivian arrives. Let us drink. To Vivian. May you find the means to aid her.
To Vivian.
Ah, when I first laid eyes on her, I finally understood what all those poems and ballads were trying to say.
Love's not poetry alone. Sometimes it's prose. Sometimes it's just plain ugly.
You say that only because you do not know Vivian as I do. A life with her would be sweetness itself.
Actually, you don't know her all that well either. Dropped something.
I demand satisfaction. You've insulted me twicely.
And twicely ought to be enough.
You refuse to duel? Then I shall show you how I treat cowards.
Oh boy.
Not your lucky day.
Oh, I'm gonna fight. I'm the biggest pussy alive. Who now will find you and touching me?
Three nothing, Ty. Might want to give some serious thought to whether you want to face me for a fourth.
I shall kill you, freak!
You got your chance, sir. You failed to seize it, and now you must leave.
We shall meet again, mutant.
Oh, mutants.
My heart swells to behold this beautiful celebration of valor and honor, and to witness you, who embody the chivalric virtues in your lives, strive for greatness. Yet, after a time of combat must come a time of peace and respite. Thus, I invite all who fought in the tourney to this feast held in your, and none other's, honor. And should any among you crave solitude, private tents await you nearby. The group melee shall take place on the morrow. Glory shall be within grasp for each and every one of you. The best among you shall have the honor to face our reigning champion, the famed Grégoire de Gourgon, victor of last year's tourney. Celebrate, make merry, revel as you will, yet be mindful of the trial that awaits you tomorrow.
Follow her. We shall meet in your tent before your last contest. You must help her.
Alrighty. Let's go do this.
That Craydome scoundrel, ever seeking Lady Vivian, sunk her maniac.
Thank you.
her. Looks like the bird's leading me somewhere.
She's a bird. Oh. Oh shit.
Ugly bastard.
Get on there.
Move it.
Okay, thank you.
Giddy up. Whoa there, Roach. Come on now.
Bird flew off over the hill. Might be quicker to pass through the cave.
Take it easy. Go, go.
Alrighty, through the cave. I will go down that way another time. Where the hell are we going?
Witcher.
Lady Vivian. Counted on me getting lost.
I did. I thought you no different from the knights. Good at tourneys, hopeless in the face of true danger. I was mistaken.
hear you come to this clearing often.
This is where it all began. And as I was not able to evade you, save myself from you, then I want it done here. In this very spot. With no witnesses.
Want what done?
Why, you are a witcher. You were hired to kill me, were you not? Then do so, now. And do it quickly, I beg you. I shan't resist.
Witchers only hunt monsters. And even then, not all. You're no monster.
Then what am I to your eyes?
Most likely you've been cursed. Don't know who by or why yet, but hope to find that out soon.
If you've no contract on my life, why take an interest at all? Did Guillaume put you up to it? Is that why?
He wanted to help you. Asked me to do him a favor. Frankly, if I can do something for you, I'll do it, willingly.
Why should I trust you?
'Cause the Duchess trusts me. 'Cause I'm a freak, too. 'Cause cases like yours are my bread and butter. Take your pick.
You shall not turn on me. Use what I say against me. You shall not tell anyone.
You got nothing to fear. Came here to help you. And I won't peep a word to anyone unless I decide it's absolutely necessary.
So be it. I shall tell you what my mama once told me. When she was with child, expecting me, she and my father spent much time together near the wood, here in this clearing. Mama loved to listen to the oriole sing. She would stroke her belly and say, "My daughter should be as beautiful as that bird. Such is my wish." But a creature dwelt in the wood who envied my parents their happiness. One day it appeared before them to say the whole wood belonged to it, and they had dared to delight in something that was not theirs. It demanded payment. And when my parents said that they had nothing, it claimed their unborn daughter as its own.
Parents ever described the creature?
They called it a nymph born of the deep woods, with no mother or father. But I was too young, too distraught by the curse's onset to ask after details.
What happened after that?
Nothing at first. I came into the world a perfectly normal child, and my parents forgot that day's events. But 15 summers into my life, the curse began to show. Initially only when the moon was full. But now it's advanced so that even in daytime I must use magic ointment to mask its symptoms, to look normal. Thus I thought someone had discovered my secret, then hired you to kill me. In fact, I was resigned to death in coming here. Perhaps death would be preferable to my complete and permanent transformation. For I fear that is what lies in store.
The curse. It could be reversible. Once ran into a baron transformed into a cormorant, ostensibly for good. Managed to cure him completely.
And you truly think you could do something like this for me?
Can't guarantee a thing. Tough case yours. You were cursed before birth. That alone complicates things. Also, you claim the curse is increasing its hold. Symptoms are progressing. Could try transferring the curse onto someone else.
What? Out of the question. I shall not allow it to ruin an innocent life. Is this the only method you know?
Only one that's completely safe.
So there is another.
All right. There is another. Ancient ritual. We'd need an oriole egg. Should release the curse's grip permanently. Gotta warn you, though. Could have serious consequences.
Consequences? What kind?
Curse was cast before you came into this world. Ritual involved transferring it to an as-yet-unhatched chick. You'd be free. Thing is, you could be left with the average lifespan of an oriole.
7 years. I understand. Alas, every rose has its thorn, and there are no happy endings. Yet truth be told, I never thought I would get one. I came here prepared to die, yet you wish to give me 7 years of life. Real life, free life. This is no dilemma. I agree wholeheartedly.
I see why. I understand. Don't have to decide just yet. Think it through.
I will. They must miss me at the Tawny Grounds by now. Shall we? Return.
Let's. But are you gonna...
Yes. I cannot appear there all in feathers. Pardon me for a moment.
Can change at will?
No, but I discovered the water of this pool helps. Its effects are brief, but I can always be sure of them.
Interesting.
Come.
Alrighty, let's go do it. Dude, it's horny.
Did you learn anything?
Yeah.
Then speak, man. Can you not see I'm out of my mind with worry? What ails her?
She asked me not to talk about it.
But I want only the best for her. Perhaps I shall be able to help or, I don't know, console her at the least.
Vivian gave me the details of her situation, but she did so in confidence. Promised I wouldn't tell anyone.
But I'm not just anyone. Why, I would do anything for her. I was the one to ask you to help her. You cannot shut me out now.
I'm sorry. Look, in time, Vivian will come to understand what she owes you. I'm sure of it. But until then, you gotta understand, the whole world doesn't revolve around you.
How dare you lecture me? This is not the aid I sought. And to think I gave up my spot in the tournament to you, I regret it now. Do you even intend to compete to the end? Or now that you've bound Vivian to your terms, you no longer see the need?
I don't back out of anything. I'll take part in the last skirmish. Besides, Vivian will be busy till the tourney's end.
Indeed. In that case, you must meet the other knights of your team. They await near the arena's entrance, by the training ground.
Got it. Thanks.
Change the mood all of a sudden.
Two teams' rosters. I shall be captain of ours. That means you shall do as I say for the duration of the fight. Is this clear? Palmer and Alonso will lead the opposing team. With this skirmish, we commemorate the Battle of Fox Hollow of 1218, when a handful of southern outlaws led by Haller the Brown attacked Tucson only to be driven off by brave knights, thus setting a precedent. Since that day, knights errant have guarded the duchy's borders. Pomeran drew the short straw, so his team shall play the barbarian Haller's men. Any questions?
None.
If you swing your blade as deftly as you shoot, we shall win. Good luck.
It is time, gentlemen. Take your weapons and proceed to the arena.
for the knights, the ladies, the lords. For our next entertainment, the team shall cross swords. Two rifle crews, two coteries shall fight full tilt till one stops to its knees. Who virtue ignores or lance blows unclean shall forever be branded as shameful, obscene. While the knights prepare, let me say I'm elated to behold such a crowd on edge, breath bated. Whoever here wins, the past champion shall face. All others must leave, heads bowed in disgrace. Let us begin! Crowd, raise a ruckus! Blood, sweat, and tears shall soon follow in buckets.
Behold! The punishment of foul deeds!
Go on! No remorse!
I shall never agree! Not one step!
How long are you gonna make me wait?
I've had just about enough of this toil. Now there's but Rathalos, though he's far from done. When all the dust clears, shall he have won?
Oh boy. Yeah, this is gonna be fun. Okay, good, I can.
I've had just about enough of this toil. No mercy! No! All together! The world's never seen a fight quite so glorious. For showing such verve, each knight was victorious. Yet in tourneys as in life, but one champion may reign. Today, he is the one. Praised be his name. He felt a whole host slew the most. To Raphics of Forhorn, who the strength of lions boasts. He sails through all trials, each test he passed with ease. But now awaits the last. Will it bring him to his knees? For Gregoire de Gorgon, who on this ground's last won, shall spar him for the title, and the day is done. To the tired remainder, we salute your endeavors. Return to your wives, your loves, your whomevers.
Get a sword or something like that. Oh yeah, I gotta fix this, dude.
It is time. Step into the arena. Should you suffer grievous harm during combat, have you any last wishes? Any missives you wish passed to your loved ones?
Thanks, I'm fine.
The brave knight Raphics hails from Forhorn. It might sound fictitious, yet there he was born. Now entering the grounds, a titan of infamy. Gregoire de Gorgon, victor of last year's tourney.
I wish both combatants good fortune and fame.
Sink the crowns, the titans locked stairs, ferocious and spry as wolves hunting bears. Mesdames et messieurs, our victor, our champion, the unequaled, yes, Gregoire de Gorgon! Hip, hip, hooray! Hooray!
And now a few words from our sponsor, the Tufo Vineyard. For strong bones and teeth, drink Tufo. A wine for your table, a wine for your soul. Champion, a sight to behold. He defeated Gregoire de Gorgon. Hail Ralphix, Ralphix, Ralphix.
I'm a winner.
As patron of this grand tourney, I've the honor to decorate our grand champion. His vow he made upon his love for his heart's captor, and it was doubtless this vow that carried him to this splendid victory! He showed great courage, great strength, great composure. He fought nobly with honor, and thus rightfully deserves the title of this year's Champion of the Arena!
I need to talk to you.
Not now. We shall meet later in my camp. I've duties to attend to, as do you. Folk will guard you. The least you should do is wave.
That's a pretty good sword.
Greetings, my lady. Have you decided?
I have. I stand by all I have said. I wish to endanger no one and thus choose the method involving an egg. If it's to be the egg of an oriole, I know where to find one. There is a nest in my clearing. Might you explain the nature of the ritual? Its exact course?
Sure, but seems your tent's grown ears. Show yourself, Guillaume. I can hear you breathing, and I know damn well it's you.
Why are you here, sir? This is a private audience. Geralt, what is the meaning of this? Is this some scheme you've hatched unbeknownst to me?
No, no scheming involved. Guillaume hired me. But this matter relates to you, not him. Didn't invite him here in any case. Actually surprised he showed up.
My lady, I live to serve you. Whatsoever you require, you need but beckon. I'm yours to command.
Are you quite finished? Is that all you wish to say?
I suppose so.
So you shall do what I command, sir. Very well, then. Listen carefully. Leave this tent, turn towards the Duchy's northern marches, and run. Run until the tawny grounds are no longer within sight. Return only once you've cooled off, and leave me be forevermore. Understood?
My lady, but your troubles... I only wish the Witcher see...
Out! Now! You assured me I could trust you!
I kept your secret. Didn't tell him anything he didn't already know.
I understand he hired you, so you had to report to him. But this is not his affair, Geralt. This is my life.
Absolutely sure you did the right thing? Not too hasty rejecting his help? Can't conduct the ritual using your reflection without him. Needed someone who'd willingly assume the curse in your stead.
And you thought I would agree to this? No, Geralt! When we spoke in the meadow, you told me of a ritual which required no lusty knights to aid us. This is the method I wish to pursue.
Need to find an egg, preferably an Oriole's. Ritual itself isn't complicated, but like I said before, there'll be a side effect. Still sure you want to go through with it?
Yes. I saw a nest in the clearing where we spoke. But before we go, tell me, what will become of the chick?
We'll have to break the egg. Like you said, not everyone gets a happy ending.
And for a dream to come true, there must be sacrifices.
Ow.
Very well. Let us go.
Oh my. This quest is almost fucking 2 hours.
This is the place.
Come on.
Oh no! A panther's got at the nest!
Stand back. I'll take care of this.
I'm gonna leave it down around here. Need to repair my sword.
Eggs fell in a moss patch. They're fine except for one. It's cracked.
Will it do?
Think so.
Now what must I do?
Just to be sure, gonna ask one last time. Positive you want to do this? If we succeed, the changes will be irreversible. You'll probably also only have 7 years left to live, at the most.
7 years free of the fear that someone might spy me at the wrong moment? Of the stigma of being a freak, a monster? 7 years of a life both true and unfettered? Yes, Geralt. I'm certain I wish to do it.
All right. need to concentrate now. Repeat after me. Muna Gandrau. Muna Finerat.
Muna Gandrau. Muna Finerat. Muna Gandrau. Muna Finerat. Muna Gandrau. Muna Finerat.
Damn it.
Geralt, look! Look! Oh, gods! I shall be able to attend balls! I shall travel to Oxenfurt, to Novigrad even! Thank you, Witcher!
Not to thank Guillaume. He's the one hired me to help you.
Yes. I'm grateful to him as well, immensely. Will you tell him so for me?
Tell him yourself, don't you think?
Perhaps I should, but I would prefer not to. Convey my gratitude to him in my stead. Please, be so kind.
Sure, I'll tell him. Farewell, Vivian.
Money. Alrighty. I need this thing's garbage. That thing is actually decent. Closest fast travel spot.
Run, Roach.
Here's again. I'll have to go up into the palace and everything.
Oh, here he comes, my hero, Geralt's dream.
What the hell?
Ollie, Ollie! Oxen free!
I pledge, my love.
Geralt, what of Vivian?
Managed to lift her curse.
Truly? So all will be well. Her troubles are done?
Asked me to give you a message. Said she's grateful. Thanks to you, she can live a normal life.
Good, good. But how does she fare?
Method she chose worked. Thing is, she might only live for a few years more. 7 or so, most likely. Though I could be wrong.
You had better be. You failed me, Witcher. I placed my trust in you and...
It was Vivian's decision. Wanted to do it her way. Can't blame me for that. Got this bard friend. Philosopher too, I guess. Amateur. He'd say, if you love somebody, set them free.
Do you know what, Geralt? You earned your reward, so take it. But keep your advice to yourself. Adieu.
Oh boy. You just take someone's meal. What's his name? He's all the way over there. This is Gwen. Is it this guy?
Greetings.
Fortune favor you.
The storm, damn it.
Banquets and
okay.
Raphix of Forhorn, greetings.
Be so kind as to show me what you have to sell. Round of Gwent, maybe?
This thing. Not a whole lot I could do. I can scorch. I really want to end up helping. Quiet. Then we'll scorch. Then all I need to do is put. Alright. That's good. That is also good. The skeleton one. Yeah, I read that wrong. I read it as that it will, put the word reduce in my head and thought of something else. I thought of, can't think of the word right now. Well, at least it will increase it by one. Don't know why I thought of that, but it is what I thought of. I'm gonna find someone who sells weapons before I end the episode off. But if I don't, then I will just end the episode off. Bank. Okay. Let me go here.
Catch it. No safer place than a bank.
Catch 22.
No.
I'm not.
Here we go.
Welcome to Gianfinelli Bank, where we look after your coin as if it were our own, and the customer's always right. How might I be of service?
I'd like to change some coin.
By all means.
Come by later.
Effort at your service, sir.
Whoops, I didn't hit the controller. Mine is up here. Why is the PlayStation super duper loud right now? Holy damn, that thing's loud for no other reason. Here we go. Let me make sure I got the best of the best stuff on. Don't really want some of that I don't care about. Sell that. Those things. I don't care if you loot anything in Tucson. Alright, let's see what Pierre.
Sacre bleu. It's a crime. You're from the north, that's painfully clear.
Excuse me?
There is no excuse. There is but the need to outfit you anew. My salon stands open. Please come in.
I just realized I had the wrong thing on.
Ever your servant, sir.
I do not like look this thing. It could be like a billion times better. I just don't like the look of it. Ah. There we go. My boots and my gauntlets and my pantyhose. I like the look of that too, but I just like the look of that more. This thing's a good bit better, but you can't put the thingies in it. Talk to Pierre again.
Welcome back to our northern dandy.
All jests aside, let me see what you got in your wardrobe.
I'm more than willing, sir.
Oh, this guy sells fucking junk. I can sell him this stuff for Thanks.
I think that's all I need for now.
Ever your servant, sir.
And talking about that, that will be it for now for this episode, and I will see you guys in the next one.